Hey guys, what's going on? Jeff here from Films at Home, and today we've got to talk about a really interesting topic that has come up because of this coronavirus pandemic. Hey everyone, so thanks for coming back to the channel. I appreciate you guys watching this video. This will be a quick one today, but I wanted to touch on some news that is going to affect both the theatrical movie industry and the home entertainment industry that's come out just in the last few hours, in the last day or so. And that is the news about AMC Theaters and Universal Studios and the kind of rift that they're in right now because of the digital release of Trolls World Tour and the success of that, and some comments made by the NBC Universal leadership team. So we'll talk about that in the video. Now, if you like this sort of stuff, Blu-ray and 4K, movie collections, home theater, home entertainment, home media, please consider subscribing to the channel. I'd really appreciate that. I have tons of great content for you to watch while we're all locked up inside, lots of reviews and interesting home theater topic videos. Also, make sure you like this video and let me know in the comments what you guys think about what I'm about to tell you and the impact that that's going to have on this movie industry as a whole. So the interesting news that came out was that Universal Studios had a great success with their release of Trolls World Tour, which was the sequel to the original Trolls movie, and they released it on digital on-demand platforms for a $20 rental because, as all you guys know right now, movie theaters are closed across most of the world, but definitely across the United States. And so Universal put this out on demand, and they made over $100 million off of on-demand rentals. And the thing with that is that 80% of that roughly goes back into their pocket, and they made a huge profit. No need to market to theaters, no need to let the theaters take their cut, no need to put up posters and promotional items in every theater. They saved a lot on marketing. They could just do online marketing, push people to a link and let them click an on-demand purchase button, and boom, they had the movie. And given that this is a family movie, I'm sure it did better than most because a lot of families are looking for things to do and things to watch with their kids right now while the kids are out of school and people are just really looking for entertainment. And so that's a big reason why it probably did so well. But $100 million in on-demand rentals is huge, considering now they can put that out on Blu-ray, 4K, and on digital and make another $100 to $200 million. It's a huge success for Universal. Now, the issue comes where Universal's leadership team, and I believe it was their CEO, started talking about the success of this and how in the future they're going to release their titles both on demand and theatrically on the same day. And that would be unprecedented for movies to do that. Some smaller movies do that. Indie movies will often go on demand and have a small theatrical run. But if you're talking about a movie like Trolls, where you've got big name talents and a ton of marketing that went into this, that's a premiere. That was going to be a premiere spring summer family animated movie for Universal, and they made this decision. And so a lot of their movies going forward could be in jeopardy because AMC Theaters took a real exception to this. They did not like these comments by Universal. And so AMC Theaters came out and they said that they will no longer play any Universal Studios movies in their theaters. That is a massive theater chain. AMC Theaters are huge. And they're currently going through some tough times, restructuring and in literally billions of dollars in debt. But they do hope to reopen when this all ends. Them not putting on any Universal movies is a huge blow to the industry, but it could really shake some things up. Now, if we talk about what Universal has coming up, they've got some incredible high budget box office blockbusters coming out, hopefully in the next 6 months to a year as all this stuff blows over. We've got the Halloween movies. We've got Fast and Furious. We've got Jurassic World. I mean, we've got James Bond. They have some absolutely monster movies that will make hundreds of millions of dollars. And AMC is basically saying we will not play them at all. And so if that ends up being the case, Universal is kind of be forced to put these movies on demand so more people will see them. But at the same time, a movie like Jurassic World, which is another huge movie that a ton of people are going to want to go see, or Fast and Furious or James Bond, that could also do $100 million. Maybe it does $200 million on demand. And then you sell the Blu-ray and 4K discs and you double your money and you take in 80% of the profits. This really could be the beginning of the end for movie theaters as we know it. And I think AMC recognizes that, and that's why they're making such a strong statement to try to force Universal's hand. But if I'm Universal, I just made $100 million, didn't have to deal with any theaters, and took 80% of the cut. That seems like a pretty good deal for me, and I think it opened some eyes over there at that studio and maybe some others that possibly on-demand and in-home viewing is going to be the future of movies. Now, AMC did say that this wasn't specific to Universal. If other studios decided to do this and take the same path, they would not show those movies either. But at a certain time, they're gonna run out of studios to show movies of if they block everybody. So I have a feeling that AMC will probably back off of this, Universal will probably back off a little bit, and they'll come to some sort of an agreement where maybe AMC will run the movie for the first 2 weeks exclusively, and then it can go on demand when AMC reopens. But it doesn't look like they're gonna be reopening anytime soon across the country. And so really, this could be the new normal as movies get released. Universal, for instance, has a new movie starring Pete Davidson. It's a Judd Apatow movie called The King of Staten Island. It was due to release in theaters on June 12th. They've already pulled that and put it on demand. And that's a Judd Apatow comedy. We're talking about, you know, possible $100 million box office there. He did 40-Year-Old Virgin. He did Knocked Up. He did This Is 40. He did a ton of these Judd Apatow. He did a ton of very popular comedies that people love to see with very popular actors and actresses. And they're now pulling his movie off and moving it to on demand. And so I could see this continuing to happen here throughout the summer, and it could really hurt the movie theater industry. Now, personally, do I think this is a good thing? Yes and no, right? I like to watch my movies at home because I have so many issues in theaters most of the time. If you go on opening weekend, people are loud, people are rude. You can't really get in that environment. But when you have a good theater showing, there's nothing like watching a great movie on a huge screen with a captive audience who really enjoys the movie. I've had multiple instances where the movie has been ruined because of a terrible audience, and the movie experience has been better because of a great audience. So it's hit or miss. But ultimately, the way prices are going, it's gonna cost me right now in the Boston area, more expensive than the rest of the country, I understand that, but it costs me anywhere from $30 to $40 to go see a movie on a Friday night and get a popcorn and a drink. That's expensive. That's 40 bucks to see a movie. I could buy two brand new release Blu-ray or 4K discs for roughly the same amount and watch those at home and get my food much cheaper. So I see where this is going. I see where this is heading. And if you think about being a family, $20 on-demand rental. Say you're a family, you're a married family with two kids. That's four people, $15 a ticket in Boston. It costs you 60 bucks to go to the movies even before you buy snacks or drinks. Now, you buy an on-demand rental, it's $20. You only get to keep it for 48 hours, but it's $20. Your whole family can watch it. You buy your own snacks, you bring your own drinks. For 20 bucks, you've got a movie night versus $60, $80, $100 for a family of four. That's the biggest difference, and I think that's why this could be where things end up. Now, will the studios make less money? Yes, because at the same time that that family of four is only spending $20, they're not buying four tickets, so you have less ticket sales technically. But that family may not have seen the movie otherwise and will pay the $20 for their whole family to watch it. So this is a really interesting new business model, and I could see this happening more and more, even with big budget, large, you know, movies like Trolls. Don't be surprised. I think Universal has decided to push back a bunch of movies. Now, don't be surprised if instead of pushing back some of these movies that are coming out in July and August and September, instead they release them on demand. I think it's a very interesting time for the world, but this is a very interesting time for the movie industry. And as much as I love going to see a movie in theaters, I want to see Halloween Kills and Halloween Ends in a packed theater. I want to see it with a respectful and engaged audience, and I can't guarantee that, But if I get this at my house and maybe you have a friend or two over, you can have that in your house for $20 versus spending $40 or $50 at a movie theater. So there's a definite appeal there. Now, how does this affect home entertainment? I honestly think that what it could do is speed up 4K and Blu-ray releases. If all you have to do is push a movie to on demand, you let that run for a few weeks, you can immediately start working on the 4K and Blu-ray release and get that out to your audience faster. You don't have theaters who want to show these movies for 6 to 8 weeks or even longer if it's a popular movie to milk as much money as they can out of it. You've got your rental, it's done. Okay, let's get the 4K disc out there. Let's sell this to the next group of physical media collectors. Let's sell this to the Blu-ray people. Let's get the DVD out there and sell it to families. So I think you could see that speed up the time lag between a theatrical or on-demand release, which is still, I guess, theatrical somehow. I don't know what they'll call that, but the difference between theatrical and home media releases, I think that gap, and it has been shortening for many years, I think it gets shorter and shorter and shorter until we could see very quick turnarounds from the time a movie is released theatrically to when you can own it in your home. So this was just sort of an interesting topic I wanted to cover because it does affect movies, it affects home entertainment, it possibly affects Blu-ray, 4K, home media. There's a ton of stuff going on here. So I want to get the news out there, let you guys know about it. I'm interested to hear your comments and discussion in the comments about what you think this is going to do. AMC so far is the only one who's come out against this, but I wouldn't be surprised if others do it because there is sort of a theater like group with Regal and AMC and Cinemark and all these big guys, Showcase, and they all are in this like North American Theater Organization, which is funnily enough called NATO. So let's see if one of them comes to somebody else's defense here and they group together. We'll see if Universal backs off, if AMC backs off, or what happens, or if others like Sony and Warner Brothers and Disney maybe start picking up on this and saying this is the new way. This is the way to make the most money, make the most profit, and not have to deal with that middleman of the movie theater, but still get this product into people's homes right when we want it to. We could have a very, very interesting next year to 18 months in the movie industry. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope this was informed. Hope it was helpful. It's a very interesting topic, and I just wanted to cover it for you all. So I appreciate you watching. Make sure you subscribed. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. The link is down in my bio, as well as a bunch of other links where you can help support my channel. I also have some new merchandise, some new t-shirts that I'm selling. So if you're interested in those, it's a really cool new design that I put together. It's simple. But I've seen this in other areas, and I thought, wow, we should do this for physical media. It's a great way to show your support for my channel, sure, but also for physical media. And I know myself, I would totally wear this shirt. So I figured I'll put it out there. I'll design it and give it to people. So I'll have a link for that down in the description as well, if you're interested in that. But otherwise, hope you guys are staying safe. Hope you're staying healthy. Hope everyone is staying sane and staying home and just doing what we can now in these tough times. But I appreciate you watching all my videos, and have a great rest of your week. I'll talk to you guys very soon with some more reviews and more interesting content like this.